Hello. In this short video, we shall look at how we can create multiple choice questions in Microsoft Excel that can grade students automatically. So, I have some questions here and I have the choices over here in column E. Well, this question, what does the acronym WHO stand for? Now, we want the student to select from a drop-down list. So what we are going to do is that we are going to create options here that will come as drop-down when the student where the student can select the correct answer. So, to do that, we select this cell and right click. Then we go to pick from drop down list. Now, we click the tab over here, data. We click this tab, then we go to data validation. We can click here and select list. So after selecting the list, we now need to select the source of our list, that is our multiple choice or our options. So we click here, then we go to this range and select this range. That should come as the possible answers for this cell. So you can input some message here. Then error alert, so we can select an info here, an information. We can select information here. So if the person enters something which is different from the options here, we can say invalid option. So we can click OK. So as soon as we do that, we can see that there's a drop down arrow here where we can click and we can see the options here. So we can do same for all the cells here. As many questions as you have, you can type the options here, then select the range, and it comes as a drop down in this cell as options for student to choose the correct answer. Now, after doing that, we can have a feedback whether the answer chosen is correct or wrong. So we can ask a cell to do that for us. So we select this cell, we enter equal to, because we are going to write a formula that will do the comparison for us. So we use the if function. So if this cell over here, so this cell, if this cell contains a value that is equal to the correct answer, we know this stands for World Health Organization. So in this case, our correct answer is this. So if B4 equal E7, then the student had the correct answer. Else, else the answer is incorrect. So we type the formula like this and then we press equal to. So that's it. I've done some corrections there. That's it. So let's test our formula and see if it is working correctly. So I click here, then I choose the correct answer, which is wife of organization. So that is correct. And if I choose any other option, it's incorrect. So we can repeat the same process for all these cells here. So when we do that, we get a drop down list for all of them as it is showing over here. Now we need to ask Excel to count the score, or to score for us, to score the student for us. So how can we do that? We can use a count if. We can use the count if function. So we type equal to in this cell, then I write a formula, count if. Count if. So I'm going to select the range. So the range is from this place up to this place. So the criteria, we are going to count only the correct ones. So correct, that is what is going to be counted for us within that range. So now I press equal to. It means as of now, there's only one correct over here. So if I select another correct answer, then we have two corrects. If I select another answer, let's say this cell two correct. If I select a wrong answer here, one correct. So if I select all correct answers, it will count all correct. Good. So now we can let the scores be visible here. So we write a formula that will give us the total score. So it will be this cell divided by 3. As of this case, we have only 3 questions. Good. Now we need to format this so that I can give the result in terms of percentage. So we right click and go to format cells. Then we select percentage here. We reduce the decimal point to 0. So that's it. So depending on the answers that the student choose, the scores will be calculated for him or her. So as we can see, the score now is 33%. Now, in order to avoid or prevent students from changing the answers, you can choose to hide these tabs, or even you can choose to create these tabs on a different sheet and lock it or restrict it from student accessing these two columns. So we can hide it. Good. So we can reset this way so that students can take it and see, know their scores.